One of you guys recently commented and asked, how do you create this 3D text inside Premiere Pro? So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to create that. But as always, if you are a patron on my Patreon page, you guys can download easy to use Mogurt template that's already ready for you guys. If you do want to support my channel and become a patron, a link is down in the video description to join. Otherwise, let's dive into Premiere Pro and see how to create this graphic from scratch. So I'm inside Adobe Premiere Pro, and what I'll first do is actually change my workspace from editing to captions and graphics. Next, I'm going to grab my type tool by hovering over the tool, clicking on it, and next I'm going to actually click on the program monitor, and I'll type out some text. Next, I'm going to grab my selection tool, and to the right under Align and Transform, I'm just going to align this to the center of my program window. Now next, you can obviously stylize this to however you wish, but I'm going to use the font Avenir Next. You can also stylize this under Appearance. I added a fill. I'm just going to leave it white for now, and I added a drop shadow to it. Next, what we're actually going to do is actually enable the ruler and create some guides for us to use as we animate the 3D text. What I'm actually going to do is hit Command or Control R on a PC. I'm going to click and drag from the top to actually create some rulers to our program monitor here. Now that we have some guides here, the next thing is to animate our 3D text. What I'm going to do is actually go to my effects panel, and the first effect we're going to type for is basic 3D. Click and drag this to your graphic, and what this allows us to do is actually animate the text in 3D space. What I'm going to do is go to the beginning of my text. I'm going to click on the stopwatch next to tilt. I'm going to go forward by holding down shift right arrow 3 times, and that'll be 15 frames forward. I'm going to click on the little diamond to make a keyframe, then go back to the beginning by clicking on the left arrow there, and then change this value to negative 90. And when we play this back, you'll notice that it animates in. What I'm going to do is right click on this last keyframe and add ease in, and that'll just ease in the animation a little bit more. And I'm going to do the same for the end. So I'm going to go to the end of the graphic, make a keyframe, go back 15 frames, make another keyframe, and change the last value to 90. So you should have something that looks like this. Next, what we actually do is have to adjust the anchor point so that way it kind of comes down from the top down, and then it kind of goes underneath as it animates out. And to do that, what I'm going to do next is actually add the transform effect to this graphic. And what I'm going to do next is actually go to the first keyframe here. So I'm going to click this left arrow here next to tilt. And then what we'll want to do is keyframe the anchor point of the transformation effect. So I'm going to click the stopwatch. Then I'm going to go to the very first keyframe, actually going to go forward 1 frame by clicking the right arrow once. And what we can do is change the Y value of the anchor point value, so that way it's at the top of the guide. And next I'm just going to click and drag this keyframe over, and then right click on the second keyframe and just ease in. And when we play this back, you'll notice what we have. You might have to go back in. If you zoom in on your program monitor, it might be a little off, so just make some adjustments here to your Y value to get it looking correct. Next, I'm going to do the same thing for the end, so I'm going to go to the last keyframe of the tilt effect, make a diamond next to anchor point, and then go to the end, and then go back 1 frame by hitting the left arrow, so that way we can see it in the program monitor, and then we're going to drag this down, so now we have something that looks like that. The next thing we want to make sure that we do, especially if we want to use this as a template or for graphics, is that we actually want to add some safe regions to the in and out animations. And you can do that easily in the effects controls panel in Premiere Pro. So with the graphic selected, you'll notice that you have these little icons in the top left and right inside the effects controls panel. What you can do is actually click and drag this out, and this will actually extend safe regions over those keyframes. And what this does, for example, if we wanted to make this graphic maybe 2 seconds long instead of 5, you can easily just click and drag to retime the graphic. You'll notice that the keyframes automatically move over. This also works when making the graphic longer as well. So just a few other notes while working with this graphic. I recommend using the transform position parameter if you need to move it. So for example, if you need to move this graphic down to the bottom center here, I recommend using the position parameter under the transform effect, not the vector motion position. And similarly, if you need to adjust the scale, I recommend actually using the scale in the transform menu of the essential graphics panel. If you actually want to save this as a Mogurt file, what you can do is right click on the file and click export as motion graphics template. And this will allow you to name it and then choose where you want to save it. And then that way you can add it into your future Premiere Pro projects. So I hope this video was helpful if you wanted to see how to create that graphic inside Premiere Pro that I use all the time in my videos. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.